That, I would like to call upon our keynote speaker for the evening, who will be talking to us about delivering the quantum leap for digital advertising. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming Mr. Amar Abrol, Managing Director and Chief Executive Officer, Air Asia India Limited.
A very good afternoon to all of you. A very big thank you to the organizers for inviting me. Little bit of a background for myself, and then setting the context for why I am here. I'm a chartered accountant by profession. I've largely worked in sales and business development, and potentially do not understand the A of advertising. Forget about digital advertising. And that is why I have my colleague, my marketing head here with me, to talk a little bit more about that. Now, having said that, the opening of the slide is here. That's not me. We at Air Asia believe ourselves to be a digital company, an airline second, and a digital company first, right? And just again, last year when I joined Air Asia, that was about, I think, April 2016. We started our digital journey here. Anupama joined us as well. And we certainly decided that the way to go in the future is a digital future. And we came up with one or two campaigns which were reasonably successful. So we'll start with that. And then I'll set the context of what digital means to me. And hopefully what we're doing at Air Asia will mean to you as an agency and as marketeers.
Macha, if you go to Delhi, na, you must have the matka peer biryani. Upam it, Hyderabad. Dum biryani. Slowly, Bangalore. Andhra biryani. Idli. But the important thing is, Macha, wherever you go, no, you must always try. Not biryani, da. Air Asia. Deals, meals, baggage, seats, everything. Full, full biryani it is.
For all destinations, there's one destination to go to. AirAsia.com.
Lakshmi, can I get some more?
Mugda tu.
शादी हैदराबाद में है ना तो फिर साड़ी भी हैदराबाद की होनी चाहिए सिकंदराबाद एमजी रोड जरूर जाना बेस्ट डील चाहिए कि नहीं मैं दिल्ली को तो पूछो ही नहीं जो अपना करोल बाग है उससे बढ़िया डीलें कहीं नहीं मिलती वाकई थोड़ा प्राइस के लिए किटकिट करते हैं लेकिन कोई नहीं अब तुझे बताऊं जो तो शादी जयपुर में बापू बाजार ऐसी डीलें मिलेंगी कि तू गश खा के गिर जाएगी माय गॉड सच्ची तो ये साड़ी की तो सारी डीले में तो बता दी लेकिन शादी तक जाने की उसका क्या और पिंकी डब्बा दिखा अपना ऐसा ले ये देख airasia.com baggage meals ticket shikar सबके ऊपर डीले my god
for all destinations there's one destination to go to airasia.com
बिट्टू के मम्मी मां बताइयो लेकिन इसके बारे में है? वैसे हमारा टीवी उनसे बड़ा हमारा 32 इंच का उनका उनका कितने का नहीं से नहीं पता 18 इंच बताओ
So these two campaigns went off very well. They were released only on YouTube and Facebook. And that was our start last year into getting into digital from here. Anybody hear me? Yeah. Okay. Just to give you a little bit of a context as to what Air Asia is, since we don't have too much of a presence in Mumbai, I'll just give you a little bit of a context of who we are across the group and then certainly in India. The airline was started about 15, 17 years ago. Tony Fernandez bought it for one ringgit from the government. And in 15 years' time, We are now one of the largest airlines, low-cost airlines in Asia, certainly if not the world. 217 planes, Airbus A320s. We fly to 133 destinations. We are 9 airlines, 9 joint ventures across this thing, which makes us, again, one of the largest joint venture airline in Asia, if not the world. AOCs is basically airline operating centers. We operate in certainly India, Malaysia, Thailand, Philippines, Indonesia, now in China, in Japan, and opening soon Vietnam and so on and so forth, right? As I said, 133 destinations, 24 countries, and we've got 16,000 people working for us who we refer to as all-stars across all of these countries. And 9 times winner of the Skytrax world's best low-cost airline. This is our sort of a very high-level snapshot of what our digital journey as a group is. To be honest, AirAsia invented internet shopping. Now, we don't take enough credit for it. 17 years ago, we were the first one who disrupted the travel industry by going direct to consumer through the web. When the big clunky computers were there, IBM, green screens were there, we basically went direct to the consumer to teach them how to buy airline tickets, how to purchase meals, and so on and so forth online. As the airline grew, we launched Big Duty Free, which is our loyalty program, and it's digital only, only available on mobile. We have recently launched Big Pay, which is our currency, our digital currency, Big Loyalty. All the planes are getting wired. Every plane, 215 planes, are gradually getting wired to provide free Wi-Fi to consumers on the plane. We launched our first ever hackathon across Asia in Malaysia in our headquarters, Red Q. We've launched our first in-flight entertainment channel. We believe that we are going to be the Amazon in the sky. Right? We transport about 45, 50 million consumers on an annual basis on our network. 45 to 50 million consumers captive in the plane. So we are going to launch the largest ever shopping catalog in the sky. We have our own innovation lab. And if you think about it, the plane is the biggest Internet of Things, and the plane is the biggest digital instrument out there. Everything is wired from an engineering perspective, from flight ops perspective, from crew perspective, and so on and so forth. In India and across the nation, across Asia, we've launched self-service kiosk, and I'll talk a little bit about that. Why is that important from a digital perspective? We've launched roving agents in a number of airports. And last but not the least, about a week ago, we announced a deep integration partnership with Uber, where Uber can be ordered through our app from anywhere in the cities, in the 124 odd cities that we operate. So we firmly believe that going forward, AirAsia certainly is going to be completely a digital airline. So what's my agenda, and what does digital mean to me as I run the company here in India? Right? And I look at it from 3 perspectives. One is certainly from a consumer perspective. Second is from an employees or an all-star perspective. And third is from the digital marketing perspective, as I mentioned. Anupama will come on stage and talk about that. And why do I choose consumers and employees? Because that will give you an insight, and that will tell you on how we are transforming. 2 things. One will give you an insight on what's happening in a company such as ours and what's happening with the consumer. It's a perfect sort of a test case of 1,500, 1,600 employees across the nation. And also, how are the consumers reacting, and what kind of consumers do we have, and how do you mold yourself if you were to work with us? So in India, this year, we are transporting 4 million guests. 2018, that will go up to 8 million guests. And pretty much every year thereafter, we're adding 3 to 4 million guests every year. Right? 26% of our guests are first-time flyers ever. Right? So we're absolutely living up to our motto of now everyone can fly. Our network is largely Tier 2 and Tier 3 cities. And 26%, one-fourth of every plane is filled with people who have never flown before. A chance to absolutely influence behavior on how do they purchase, how do they check in, and how do they go through the entire journey from a digital experience perspective. 49% of the flyers experience AirAsia for the first time ever, every time they fly. 50% of them have never flown with AirAsia, and they get to experience our product for the first time. Again, a huge opportunity on telling them about the brand and what we stand for and what we offer. 50% of our guests are between the ages of 16 to 35. I was having a meeting with early on with one of the reporters from a publication. I said, again, you know, literally catch them young and watch them grow. So whatever we teach them, whatever we tell them right now is how they are going to interact with our product going forward. And our app is doing fantastic. A 4.5-star rating for the app, certainly on the Apple Play Store. And again, to promote mobile, all of our fares, whether it's cancellation charges, fees, et cetera, everything is 10% lower. As I said, we are basically wiring up planes. We're launching Big Pay, which is eliminating cash from the planes. We've tied up with Uber. And that on the corner there is the self-check-in kiosks, which we have launched in Bangalore Airport and in Delhi Airport. From a customer perspective, right, so we've invested again very heavily in technology. In the last 1 year, we've completely integrated and bought every bit of the customer interaction into Salesforce, right? So earlier, if a consumer was calling for a refund or for a change of meal, change of destination, there were different teams and there were different people across the globe interacting with them. Now, with Salesforce, everything is in one place. The entire consumer experience is in one place. As we go through this journey, we will learn the habits of the consumer a lot more, and we'll be able to offer customer personalization as this journey of digitalization begins. We get about 25 million telephone calls, which are now recorded in one place. 25 million telephone calls across our network, across all of the countries that are now all getting recorded in Salesforce. We get about 7 million emails, which are of customer complaints, of customer compliment, of service requests, and so on and so forth. Again, teaching us a lot as it's getting captured into one place and as we move into artificial intelligence to understand what personalization do we need to offer to the consumer. I'll move swiftly on to employees. As we said, we refer to our employees and our team as all-stars, right? In India right now, we are 1,600 people, going up to 2,600 people by next year, and increasing to about 5,000 all-stars by 2020. So very, very rapid expansion. And 81% of the team that works for us is in the age group of 18 to 34%. And probably the most interesting statistics is only 26% of our staff has actually computers. Everybody is doing their work, or 75% of my workforce is working on mobile. We don't even issue laptops anymore. And we are phasing out email. We're completely phasing out email, and the two tools that we work on are provided by Facebook, that is Workplace and WorkChat. The entire interaction is through photos, is through tweets, is through work chat groups, and so on and so forth. So we are digitizing as the demand, to be honest, is of the generation. Nobody is carrying laptops nowadays, at least vast majority of the youth population. Nobody is interested in writing lengthy emails. And we are moving with the times in the company. With partnering with Facebook, and we provided the work chat and workplace for this thing. All our expenses, again, the teams are perpetually traveling. They're perpetually in the plane. All our expenses, which is a really huge thing, is managed on Concor. We are investing very heavily in e-games. Again, there's a huge, huge investment going on in e-games because that's the future as well, right? Especially with the generation that's working with us. Our entire interaction from hiring to managing the workday, payroll processing, all of that boring stuff is also moving on to workday, right? Complete digitization, everything will be available on mobile. Your leave, how much leave do you have? How much bonus are you earning? How much sales incentive are you going to earn? And so on and so forth. Everything is going to be available on mobile. No more emails, no more clunky computers. That's where we are moving as a company. And here is another reason, right, and why we are changing and why we are becoming digital in every way. I don't think a lot of people who don't work for an airline realize just in the cockpit itself, we carry on every flight anywhere between 25 to 30 kgs of paper. Right? If you enter a cockpit, it is absolutely strewn with paper when the plane is flying. 25 to 30 kgs, the amount of fuel that is consumed just to carry paper, right, to fly a plane is unbelievable. So there is no choice as we are low cost. We are moving to e-bag. Everything is moving on to an Apple platform, and basically all of the electronic bag, the huge bags that the captain carry, will disappear. Our cabin crew, on a daily basis, there's about 300 cabin crew that works for us right now. 850 pieces of paper are filled by them on a daily basis. This is the sales that is done, the security report that is filled, and everything in that nature. Everything right now is on paper, and that's all going to be moved as we convert to Rocky, as we move to Wi-Fi, and as we introduce EPOS. To get to 4,000, we're going to get to about 21 planes and then to about 40 planes by next year, we need to hire about 2,000 people. Hiring 2,000 people means at least a minimum of 10,000 interviews to be conducted for cabin crew. We are very picky on who we choose, who flies with us. So 10,000 interviews to be conducted, paper forms to be filled out, assessments to be filled out, all of that is going, right? So every part of the company, not only digital advertising, every part of the company is being digitized as we move forward. We're investing very, very heavily in technology, and every bit on how interaction is going to happen with the consumer, how interaction is going to happen with the cockpit, how interaction is going to happen with the cabin crew, is all transforming into digital, right? So that's a little bit of a snapshot, a few snippets of where AirAsia is moving. And I'd like to call Anupama now on stage, probably for the more interesting stuff, which you're here for. And then certainly we'll be able to take questions as appropriate. Thanks, Anupama.
Thank you. Thank you, Amal. Okay, so just quickly taking over from there. Amal. So I think what we'll discuss today is the agenda is more about where the digital advertising is moving and where the digital advertising spends. But I think what Amal brought alive is what goes behind that company. Okay, it's not only about marketing and advertising spends, but the entire ecosystem has to transform. Okay, now just quickly align. If you see, this has been the marketing story of AirAsia in 2017. I joined here in 2016. It's almost 1.5 years. And we truly believe that we have, as a company, taken in the aviation space a quantum leap when it comes to digital. Okay? Our spends has grown from 17 crore to 21.8, which is, and this growth is larger than the category. Digital as a part of overall spends in 2017 stands at 30%, which is also more than what the category is. Overall user growth on our website and app has been phenomenal. Now it's grown in 17, it grew by 140%. And we are targeting the youth. So 18 to 13, 34 age group, it jumped phenomenal, like from 4 million to 9.2 million, which is more than double. Okay. Our users and social have doubled. And the Facebook page of AirAsia is one of the most engaged page, you know, mediums, platforms in India. And as Amar showed those two TVCs, I think, that we did on digital. So this has been one of our biggest campaigns in 2017. And the lead medium was digital. Okay. We only supported with few outdoors and stuff through offline, but we completely ran the campaigns on YouTube, Facebook, Hotstar, and supplemented by display. And in fact, in this entire journey, our app base for specifically for AirAsia India stands at 1.4 million. Which is in fact larger than few of our biggest competitors because they have more capacity share than what we have. And this entire thing has led us, led AirAsia India to grow to 4.3% market share when it comes to aviation market currently in India. Just quickly, I think Anurag already talked about in that one slide itself how digital is transforming our world. But I think in terms of what Digital India is doing, we are second in the world with 34% internet penetration. When it comes to mobile, 80% of the traffic has just gone very swiftly to mobile. We are spending almost so many hours a week on mobile. We have already beaten US in terms of app downloads. And by 2021, will consume 32,000 video minutes every second, which is phenomenal. Okay. And who are these users? So these are two types of users. I think for every marketer, this is the point to kind of make a note. So one is the evolved user, which is majorly from a metro, who is more educated, speaks or converses mostly in English, and has 3G and 4G connection, and easy for a marketer to target. But I think the focus is also to how to, from a communication and media channel perspective, how to target the new users, which is more of an India too. This is from study run from YouTube we have picked up. Okay. And this audience is very different from the India One users, because India One were both desktop and mobile exposed. But if you look at the India Two, they have experienced internet through mobile itself. Okay. And maybe they are still with living with 2G sort of services, and they are mix of urban and rural. Okay. And as you see, the digital spends is growing more than what the overall spend is growing, and it has already formed 15% of the overall pie. In India, it stands close to 12%. Sorry, what happened? Yeah. And I think one very interesting point to note is what's new in digital marketing actually changes every day, okay? So if we quickly look at globally, digital spending has crossed TV for the first time in 2017. Nearly two-thirds of display ads have moved to programmatic, though there's a lot of discussion around programmatic, how to do, whether it's right the stuff, and from a marketer point of view. Big data is changing the entire thing in terms of customer experience and personalization. In fact, in AirAsia also, we have started, like our homepage, we have started a lot of personalization exercise in which people will see the relevant stuff that they have searched last, okay? And then in terms of app, this is very interesting that we download close to 8 apps per month. But the interesting point for a marketer is that 25% of them are never used and 26% are abandoned after the first use. So from an app strategy perspective, we need to really target the right user who will kind of be hooked onto my app, and there'll be a longer stickiness rather than just having it deleted from the mobile. I'll skip this one. Okay. Quickly, so after this, as a marketer, I believe there are two things. One is, okay, increasing the spends in digital is eventually happening. And we'll see that, as Anurag also spoke, by 2021, we will see this pie increasing maybe 30-35%. We don't know what exactly it will land up to. But two things will really help. So one is the moment marketing, and later on I'll speak about keep it real, okay? So moment marketing can be two things, like for a personal perspective, when in the day that person is the most engaged. So I think the best example for it could be a job email coming early in the morning. So if that person is looking for a job, that's the right time to target him or her. And another is more timing perspective. So if there is something happening in the ecosystem, How as a brand I can increase my chance to engage in that conversation, be a part of this conversation, and create more content around it. Okay? So this is where I think the recent burger emoji debate which happened, where Google had another emoji where they placed the cheese down and Apple put the cheese up, and there were a lot of conversation, and then we had the biggest influencer, Sundar itself, talking about this, that we'll get it corrected. I think the beauty, the content got amplified when actually KFC and McDonald's came into the conversation, where they put up their video and taking a take on this. So McDonald's came that you guys keep on debating, but we make the best burgers, whether it's the cheese is up and down, doesn't matter. And KFC took completely different angle that we don't have buns, we have complete chicken burger. So why don't you come to? I think this is one example where it created a lot of conversations. Just a simple tweet from some person made so much engagement on the social platform. And Amul, as we all know, it's one of the veteran moment marketing. They do in print, and now they have carried all their stuff in. They have launched their app, which carries all these ads, which we are seeing since our childhood. And in our small way, in AirAsia, we did this in Valentine's campaign, where we told that love is, where we try to say that love is in the air. So no matter if we are our competitors are big than us, so Indigo is the biggest competition, then SpiceJet, and then Jet Airways. But when we are flying in the air, we are friends, okay? So friendly rivalries, if done in good taste, can be a great thing. I think I had a video, but it's somehow it's not playing, so I'll skip this. Just 1 second. Yeah, it's playing now. Saying that love is always in the air and the fun is in the flying, and with zero spend we could reach those numbers that you see in that red box, and we could have all our competition engaging with this campaign in a very positive manner. And the second thing which I really believe is you can buy likes but not love. So as a marketer, we need to keep it real, because the moment marketing reached the web, the audience has become omnipotent. Keeping it real never has been more important than what it is today. Because as a marketeer, we need to tell a story, but it has to be a rightful story. Because with the advent of digital, what has happened? The power of consumer replying back, reaching out to brand has happened, which was not there when it was just an offline way of advertising. So brands have to be more real. They need to sound that they're they have to actually solve the consumer problem and keep the story very real, and not like I'm doing so and so at a very, you need to spend very less, but what you'll get is very good. But the product has to actually deliver that. Okay. So we believe that two of these brands, there are many others, okay, but they have done a really good job of keeping it real. So one was the entire story campaign that Bajaj did with INS Vikrant. And in fact, the brand took it further forward by saluting various invincible Indians through this campaign. And we all know what Tata Tea did with Jagore. Okay, so they took this functional benefit and created a movement out of it, which is still phenomenal. Still, you kind of will look forward for what is happening in this space, and has been done by Tata. And in our small way, again, at Air Asia, I think when it started 16 years back, we said that as a tagline, we want to say now everyone can fly. This is what the vision of Tony Fernandez, who is Group CEO, is. It was a tagline, but it needed to be reinforced within the system until a brand was born. And we believe that today in India, it is the right time to say that now everyone can fly, because the kind of route choice, fares that enable, and the kind of, we are more like a low cost, pay for what you use and not kind of, you know, bundle it everything. Okay. So we are yet to fly to Mumbai, but I think we are slowly making our headway to the entire country. Yesterday only we launched Chennai and Bangalore Chennai and Chennai Bhubaneswar, and our focus is more and more connecting metro to the tier 2 and tier 3 sort of places. And as Amar spoke about it, and the entire data of that 26% of our audience is people who have not flown, I think this is really big achievement as a brand or as an organization that we have kind of created in India. I have worked in telecom and e-learning and education and the aggregator cab space, but I never knew that aviation could be so exciting. And the entire 365 days of last year has been just thoroughly going, as in it's like every moment is just very happening moment in this company. So with this, I think I'll end what Amar and we wanted to share. This is one of the Kabali campaigns that we did that really created a good recall in. It was more southern centric, but I think the PR noise that it created was across India. Thank you. Yeah.
Thank you so much for talking to us about the Air Asia digital story. Amar, I'd request you to kindly join me once again. We'd like to present you with a memento, a token of our gratitude. I'd like to... Sure. Yes, I think we can... Do we have a couple of minutes? Okay, we do.
Happy to answer any questions that you may have, if any. No? Brilliant. Makes my life easy.
Oh, yes. All right, I'd like to invite on stage Mr. Ashish Basi. Sir, if you could please join us, Chairman and CEO, Dentsu Aegis Network, to kindly present a token of our gratitude to Amar and Anubhav. Oh, we do have a question, though, so we'll probably take that up right now.
Sale of Air India on a digital conference. We are from news channel, so you know we'll ask such.
Why don't we talk about that offline? I don't think anybody else will be interested in Sale of Air India from a digital perspective.
No, but they said ask question. They did not say ask question on digital. So.
So what's the question? Yeah, the Sale of Air Asia is happening.
So do you think that any of the current existing player in India, and like Air Asia, Indigo, Spice, they're all doing very well. Do you think any of them would be looking at the piece of pie out of that?
I think I can only speak for myself. I can't speak for the other airlines, to be honest, right? But they've already made public statements with regards to their intent, and they've said what they had to say. From our perspective, again, without boring the vast majority of the people here, we are very focused on building our brand. We have 15 planes right now, going on to 21 planes, and we will never say no to an opportunity. But at this point of time, very, very focused on growing business in India, pretty much on the formula that and the strategy that we have, which does not include a purchase of a state-owned airline.
And one question for the crowd's sake. So when is the digital boarding pass would be available in India?
I think it's coming soon. So Bangalore airport is very progressive. We are working with Bangalore airport right now for a complete digital journey through facial recognition. It is the beta test is going to start in about a month's time. And the Ministry of Civil Aviation has also stepped in to make sure that there's a uniform standard. So whenever any airport rolls it out, we will follow the same standard, right? So it is, I think digitalization is big on everybody's mind, certainly on the airport's mind. There is no space for more counters. There is no space. The sector is growing. It's up 20-25% year on year, right? Therefore, digitalization is the way to go, whether it's kiosk, self-check-in, mobile, what have you. It is happening, and it's going to happen even at a faster click.
That's enough.
Do we have any other questions? Okay. Yes, Mr. Basin, you can do the honors now.
Thank you so much.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's have a round of applause for Mr. Abrol and Anubhav. Thank you very much once again.